As mentioned, all these cutouts are available in Piranesi 2010 Pro. Place the pin. The cutouts are explained in more detail in the cutouts tutorial, which can be found on our website. Placing the rubbish bin and aligning it to the wall. Do the same with the second one. And I can tweak it and align it. I can then go on to adding people. I can place the men there, or I can hide the glass and place him inside. Turn the glass back on, choose the glass layer and reduce the opacity, and he's visible now. Once I've got all my cutouts in place, I can now start adding artistic styles. All existing Piranesi users will find that you no longer need to burn in cutouts to apply your artistic styles. I can create a new layer and click the style. This particular style is a multi-fill style that goes through various stages of an artistic style, and again is available in Piranesi 2010 Pro. You can create your own styles and apply them using a new layer. That's it. I can now add a new layer and call it Style 2. Can hide the artistic style, and I can go in and apply a style of my own. This layer feature helps you create various different styles using the same textured image. You do not need to start afresh. And you can use multiple styles on the same image. Reduce the blend mode to bring out a little bit more off the building. I can now start restoring the textures. As mentioned, I can work up any style I want. Increase the amount of texture that comes through. I'm using a material lock so it only brings out the material that I clicked on originally, and I can start bringing out the different areas. Bring out the paving. And the tree. And the grass area. I can get rid of the grain and bring out the clock face. The glass. I can go back into the overlay at any time and fill in paint. I can go back to my style and finish it with highlighting the edges. Any point I can restore it to the original image, or I can use any one of the styles. This concludes our layers tutorial. Thank you for watching.